not in the club. What they giving up? Bust it open, huh? Let me see your job. Get down in the club.
Time for a shakedown. Good, yeah.
So, Drew picked up a new rig about 3 weeks ago. We are headed out to Tahuya for a shakedown run with his new first-gen Tacoma. But before we do, let's hit that rewind button real quick.
So we are in Burlington, Washington, about an hour and 45 minutes away from the Tacoma area. Meeting up with this guy that Drew found on Marketplace selling his Tacoma. Pretty good platform for Drew to build on. So anyway, we're here. Well, they are not here. Drew and the guy got in the truck and they went and they're doing a test drive right now. So I'm just waiting for them to come back to see what happens.
Back up a foot and you'll be fine. There you go, full passenger.
undercut right there. Take it just a little bit at an angle. Someone would just watch her and go do the same line.
Yeah,
it pushed you back forward.
Hell yeah.
Long man life.
Yes, sir.
Good shit, dude. How'd that feel?
Good, man. Good. Super dialed. I like it.
Big rock over here. You wedge right up in it. Hard, hard driver. Finger low. Theee.Krisss. Just so that it clears the slider. Please tell me your weight is little.
I have no idea what the actual name of this rock garden is, but it's one of those fun ones that I like to mess around in whenever we drive by it. If you know the name of it, drop it in the comments below. Let me know.
He went a different line that time. He went on the inside.
I want to help film Drew. Sometimes wait. I'll help you film him.
I got him.
You're good.
right on the tip on the driver. Going down. Hold on. Hold on.
Thanks. Huh? My head's good. It was my sunglasses that fell off.
You got a scratch on the brand new slider, Drew.
Oh, thanks.
There you go. Drew, smile.
Rare, you might hit the bed.
Okay. Just go slow. Slow, slow, slow. And then you're coming up on the front too. Ooh. Good old bumper. Woohoo!
One more passenger. There you go.
I remember somebody saying you go straight
for
the stump.
Yeah, you go straight for the stump so you can go more passenger and you can cut it back this way. Cut it back this way. There you go. Yep, straight up. Oh, you're in an undercut.
What's that?
You're in a big wedge. Oh. Don't hit it too hard. Just go slow. Okay, straight. Back up real slow and see if it'll pick up. Just go straight back.
Well, I can't. I gotta turn.
Hard driver. freaking out. Hang on, Chris. Hang on, Lich. She's on a big drop on her right rear, Sean. Dip on the rear. Rear is going to drop down slowly.
Now go past
her. Right there.
Okay. Hold it off. Now go park driver. Go passenger and go forward. You want to try something. Okay.
Forward.
Just crawl it. Go low.
She's cleared the diff.
Now go driver.
Nope. Yep, she cleared the diff.
So back up, keep it turned the way it is until you get past this pointed rock. So back up the bottom.
Get her to scrub the fucking stuff.
You think try and drive up it?
No, scrub it.
Okay, hold it right there, Chris. Chris, hold it right there for a sec. Alright, hold right there, Chris.
Alright, I just work here sometimes.
Yeah.
Just try a little bit. Go back further and then go. Go into. Now go driver and forward.
Yeah.
Keep crawling. Too much,
Chris. Go back passenger a little.
Yeah, not so much starting. Passenger a little bit.
Come up too, because you're dropping
right
down. Come up, come up, come up. Come up, Chris, come up. Hard driver. The 3-4 made a huge difference after
the extra torque.
Yeah, like on the dual case.
Fucking bad propane right
there. That's about to be the setup I have, except for it's 22
on. Let it eat. You're okay, let it eat. Trying to go a little bit past the grip position.
Sounds good.
Now you're gonna start coming over.
The transmission.
Like no fluid pressure.
Yeah, over here. It's coming. It's coming out, Drew.
It's coming out?
Yeah, it's starting to turn. Give it a little gas, it'll come back. There you go.
There we go.
Yeah.
What's up, guys? DruBilt here. Just got done at Tahuya. It was a good day. Definitely got some things to change and fix on the rig. I'll go through it for you real quick, just to show you what I'm working with. So what really got my attention of this truck when I saw it for sale was it looked fairly normal on the outside, but when you look under it, it's a three-link solid axle swapped with a TG rock assault housing running 488s and a Yukon locker up front. Full ORI kit, front and rear, 12-inch stroke. Has a three-link WFO kit, which is really cool. Steering is all Heim joints, has hydro assist, TG steering box, TG ram mount, Bobby Longs, whole nine yards, you name it. But it's fully set up front. Bumpers are Coastal off-road bumpers, front and rear. So it has armor.
And it hides your winch.
It does, yeah, hides the winch. All pro side rock sliders. And then the rear is my favorite. Rear four link, trail gear rear axle, fully trussed. The trail gear rear brake disc conversion. ORIs in the rear, they stick out through the bed a little bit up top, which is pretty cool. Everything's really well done. The walls are nice. Yukon locker in this as well. Yeah, I mean, it's pretty solid. When I first got the truck, still some stuff that need to be done, like the ORIs need to be tuned. The engine is a 3.4 with the V6 auto behind it. Needed cam seals, needed timing belt, like it needed some work. So basically tore the engine apart, gave it new seals, refreshed it up, made that all solid, and then tuned the ORIs, which I think I like where they're at right now. They ride pretty good, they flex pretty good. Yeah, other than that, it's a solid rig. Like there's not really much to it other than like the frame has a lot of work done. So it's kind of like a sleeper crawler, really. Like you see it driving down the road, you might just think it's a truck with oversized tires, but if you really know what you're looking at, you would know.
But and how did it do today?
It did good.
Yeah.
It did good. Yeah. Made it up Sasquatch. Did Yellow Jacket. Tried doing twin rocks on the left line, but I ran into an issue where as soon as I got it really off cambered. There was no pressure from the transmission, so low, drive, reverse, there was nothing unless I really gassed it, which tells me the transmission fluid is low. So check the dipstick, fluid's low for sure, so I'm gonna flush out the transmission and give it some new fluid. Then after that, should be able to try it round two and be good. But other than that, it did solid, it was good.
Nice.
Yeah.
That was quick. Putting your truck up on the trailer.
Oh, drive right up there.
Man, your truck killed it today.
It went right up twin rocks.
It was like rock versus diff and then diff won every time.
Yeah.
What's the plan for the truck?
Get new burr fields, I guess. Probably new manual locking hubs, lockers, home all the axle shafts. Hydro assist.
Yeah.
And then probably, I need spacers or bushings for the leaves. And apparently these calipers are placed in the front, so that's gotta be right. And then that's probably it. Like those are the high priority items right now, so.
Well, it turned out to be a fun day out in Tahuya, as it always is. The 4Runner never ceases to amaze me. I had a blast on the rocks today. Finally made it up the left side of Twin Rocks, thanks to my amazing spotters. It was a great day overall for everyone. I have a few events coming up with the Forerunner that I can't wait to share with you. So be sure to hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications so you'll know the next time I drop my next video. Don't forget to hit that thumbs up button and drop me a comment below. Thanks so much for watching. Until the next one, aloha.